snack. Me and you gonna have a little chat about books. Hi guys, I am here today to do my top 14 books of 2014. I am very excited to show you guys all of these books because they are all 5-star books in my opinion. You should definitely pick them all up. They're pretty much all fantasy. I think there's only one that isn't fantasy. They are amazing and you guys should certainly go and pick these up and read them if you've not already, because I would highly recommend these. Let's get started. So these are not in any particular order. They are all just amazing, amazing books in their own right. Enjoy. Book number one, Battle Royale by Koshin Takami. This is the non-fantasy book that I've mentioned. This is very, very brutal. It is about a school which gets selected to go and take part in this sort of trial type thing, and they basically have to kill each other. All of their classmates have to die, and there will be one winner of the whole thing. It is compared to Hunger Games a lot. It's not like Hunger Games at all. It's not a dystopian type of world. It's just a world where some really messed up things happen, and this is one of those very, very messed up things, the Battle Royale. It's very, very cool. It's very action-packed. It's filled with blood and gore. If you don't like that sort of thing, don't read this series. But if you can handle that, certainly check this one out. I really enjoyed it. It was very fast-paced. I read it really, really quickly and really, really interesting. Now on to all the fantasy. I read number 6 in Wheel of Time, Lord of Chaos, this year, and I have read a couple of the Wheel of Time books this year. But number 6 was by far my favourite because of Demias Wells, which happens at the end of this book. If you guys have read this series, you know what I mean. It is amazing, the ending. This is so dramatic, so climactic. Everything kicks off. There's some very, very dark moments and there's some very tense moments where you don't know what's going to happen. And a lot of the characters that we know and love get into tricky situations. It's amazing. The whole of Wheel of Time is a really, really, really cool series. The character development and the world of the Wheel of Time is utterly stunning, but this book so far has been my favourite. I'm currently on book 9, so I can't comment about the rest of them, but this one was really good and it was definitely a 5-star solid read for me, so highly recommend this. Next, I have volume 4 of Saga, which is by Brian K. Vaughan and Fiona Staples. I absolutely love Saga, the graphic novel series. I read all the volumes 1 to 4 in 2014 and I really enjoyed them all, but I think that number 4 is probably my favourite just because it's very action-packed and we have a lot more character progression and the storyline takes a few new interesting twists and turns. So again, this is a sci-fi graphic novel and kind of fantasy as well. It's got a huge amount of different races. You go across all sorts of different planets, rove around the universe. So much kicks off. The artwork's amazing. The whole thing is coloured beautifully. And I could not recommend this graphic novel series higher. It is one of my absolute all-time favourite graphic novel series. And I'm so happy I picked this up because it is so worth the hype that it gets. Number 4 is one that I read very close to the end of the year, so very recently. And this is by J.V. Jones. It is A Cavern of Black Ice, and it's the first one in the Sword of Shadows series by her. I actually own the second and third, and I really want to get to them because this book blew my socks off. Literally, it was amazing. I had no idea I was going to love this so much. I think it is comparable to so many good writers out there, like George R.R. Martin, Patrick Rothfuss. I would say this is better than both. I loved it. I think her writing is absolutely amazing, and I'm so glad I discovered her because she certainly has already gone onto my favourite authors list. I will definitely be picking up the next two very soon. This is a story which is set in a world where there are ice nomadic sort of tribes and they travel around and we follow a few different characters. There is magic in the world, but it's quite sinister and dark and it's just amazing. You guys should totally go and pick up this series if you have not already because I absolutely loved it and I'm so excited to continue. If you have read any other J.V. Jones, then certainly let me know because I absolutely loved this book and I cannot wait to see what else she has written. A lot of you guys have recommended other books by her, so yeah, definitely going to happen in 2015, I hope. Next, I have Assassin's Apprentice, which is by Robin Hobb, and this is the first one in the Farseer trilogy. I am currently reading book number 3 in the series. I have already read the second one, obviously. I much preferred the first one to the second one. I think this one was more interesting. I still love the second one, but this one I preferred overall, and the third one I'm not far enough through to judge. So yeah, Robin Hobb is an amazing writer. She writes really, really beautifully, and her character development and the convincing nature of her characters is really, really good. So again, another highly, highly recommended one. This is the story of Fitz, who is a bastard of the prince, and he basically grows up in a keep where he is not really wanted around, but people kind of accept him because of his status. However, having the status of a bastard is not really being accepted, and he has a lot of struggles that he has to face in order to progress with his life. And this is a really, really great book, so if you've not read this, definitely pick it up. Next, I have volume 1 of the Rieria Revelations, which is by Michael J. Sullivan. This contains The Crown Conspiracy and Abinpartha, which are two different books. I loved this book. It was amazing. Michael J. Sullivan is a very, very awesome writer. He writes very similarly to Scott Lynch, which is very cool because I absolutely adore Scott Lynch as well. And he has two characters within this who are very, very funny together. They make an excellent duo and are very, very hilarious with some of the scenes that they come up with and the banter that they have together. They are called Hadrian and Royce, and the characters within this are just very, very funny. It's quite a light-hearted read. I really enjoyed it, and I would definitely be continuing on with this series very soon because it's one of my most loved series. So happy I finally picked this one up because a lot of you guys and a lot of people on Goodreads had all recommended this to me, so I cannot wait to see where this story goes because the ending of this one was explosive and amazing and cool. Next, I have The Wise Man's Fear, which is book number 2 in the Kingkiller Chronicles by Patrick Rothfuss. I love this book. I think it was absolutely amazing. The detail of his world is so, so good. It's uncomparable. Even though I said J.V. Jones is better, I still think he is absolutely stunning and his vision is so creative. I cannot compare his character development of K'voth with anyone else because it's so different and so unique. There are some really, really awesome characters within this. Ori is a favourite. I cannot wait to read The Slow Regard of Silent Things, which I have. But yes, this book is just a monster of a book and it's amazing. We really get to explore a little bit further away from the university and a little bit wider into the world, which is really great. And overall, I would highly recommend this series and this world and K'voth and Ori and just everything Rothfuss to you guys because he's really hilarious and fun. Next, I have Blood Song, which is by Anthony Ryan. This book is so good, so good. I was not expecting it to be that good because I'd never heard of Anthony Ryan before now, but reading this book, it was utterly amazing. It's the first one in the Raven Shadow series. I have indeed read the second one, but I didn't enjoy that one quite as much. This one I thought was utterly uncomparable. It was so cool. It was all about a character called Valen, who is a really, really young character when we first meet him, but we follow his life as he grows up and we follow the society that he's brought into. He becomes a brother and he has a lot of other companions who he's really, really close with. They all grow up together and go through the same trials, and it's very, very lovely to see them as a group of friends and the way that they bounce off of each other through hardships and they learn from things that they do together. It's just a really, really wonderful tale, and I could not wait to get the second one, which unfortunately wasn't as amazing for me, but I'm really excited about the third one still and I cannot wait to see how that continues. This book, though, as a standalone or as the beginning of a series, a trilogy, is amazing, so pick this one up. Next, I have Ready Player One, which is by Ernest Cline. I really enjoyed this book, even though I wasn't sure if I was going to. It has a very gamer kind of feel to it. It's all about an interactive game online, which people can log into and they can spend basically their whole lives and hours at a time living in the world of Oasis, which is the online community. This was a really cool book. It has a lot of references to sort of 80s and 90s games, which is really, really cool. I didn't know enough about that to get all of them, but it was still a utterly amazing book and I would highly recommend this. It's quite a short one as well, so you can get through it fairly easily. It's very action-packed, a lot of cool stuff happens. It's just very, very gadget-driven, which is really cool because that's not something you see a lot in fantasy. This is definitely more sci-fi. I think Ernest Cline is an approachable writer and I cannot wait for his new book, which is due out in 2015. So very excited about this. Next, I have The Night Circus, which is by Erin Morgenstern. This is an adult fantasy book. It's a standalone and it's utterly stunning. The visuals that I got from reading this were so cool. It's all about a circus which travels through the night and they move around every few nights they will go to a new destination and no one will know that they are coming, no one will know when they are leaving. We basically follow a few of the people inside of the circus. They have some really, really amazing things that go on within this circus. There's a little bit of magic involved and it's just crazily cool. The vision that she creates is stunning. Her writing is very, very good at bringing everything to life and making it so believable and so clear to imagine. I absolutely love this. The shades of things that she brought to life were stunning. You have to read this one, guys. It's amazing. So highly recommend that one. Next, I have a few Brandon Sanderson books because I read quite a few this year. The first one is Warbreaker, which is by Brandon Sanderson. This book is about a world where breath and colour are basically the magical systems. In this world, you have two different societies and kingdoms. One of them is called Helandrin and the other one is called Idris. Idris is a fairly small scale kingdom where there is not much colour and people don't really appreciate colour. They don't like the fact that it's associated with royalty and magic and they like to kind of keep themselves to themselves. Whereas in Helandrin, it's very much a different culture. It's very exotic. It's all to do with colour and vibrance and extravagance. And one of the princesses in this book is sent over to Helandrin to marry the God King, who is a very, very powerful being. She discovers all sorts of various different things going on within that society, all sorts of secret things that are happening. Every person in the world is born with one breath inside of them, but you can convince people to give up their breath, and their breath can basically animate things. It can be used to do all sorts of really, really cool things. And if you can store up a large amount of breath, then you will be a very, very powerful person. I thought that this was certainly an underrated Sanderson book. I think it's definitely more deserving of higher praise. I don't think a lot of people have read this one, but I really, really love this book. And I know that there is due to be a second one, which will be out sometime in the future whenever Sanderson gets around to it because he's got so many other projects. But I'm really, really intrigued to see more from this world because it's one that I really enjoyed, and the use of colour and artsy stuff and breath in general was just so cool. So magic system that I really, really like. Next, I have book number 3 in the Mistborn series, which is Hero of Ages. This was the kind of tie-off for the trilogy, and my god, this is amazing. The ending of this book and the craziness within this book is so good. So good. I did not guess any of it, and it was so much fun to read and discover and find out how everything fitted together. Everything that was hinted at and woven into the story from the last two books was drawn together in a really succinct and very, very cool, exciting, dramatic way. We discover a lot more about the Cosmere and we discover a lot more about the world in general. It's amazing. It's so good. There are some characters within this who become amazingly interesting and cool and have really cool plot lines. You've got to read this series, guys. I absolutely adored it. Certainly recommend this one. Next, I have Words of Radiance, which is book number 2 in the Stormlight Archive. I would include both, but I thought, no, I'm just going to include one in my favourite 2014 books because it would be crazy to try and hold up two because one is bad enough. And the series as a whole is amazing, so I'm sure you guys already know that. This series is so cool because this is basically the pinnacle of everything Sanderson has worked towards for his whole life. He has been writing various different books with various different magic systems in various different planets in the Cosmere, which all slightly tie together. But this one is basically the culmination of all of that, and it's the start of joining that together in a really clear way and making everything sort of tie into one. He has basically created everything in this world. He has created different cultures, he has created different environments, he has created different people, he's created different tribes of people, he's created the different animals, different plant species. He's literally done everything, and it's so cool to see inside his brain and see what is going on because it is really, really awesome in there. I absolutely adore this book. I actually cannot wait for the third one to come out because I know that it's going to be so, so cool. There are meant to be 10 books in this series. I am highly anticipating each and every one of them being released, and I will certainly be picking them up ASAP because they are amazing. Cannot recommend this one to you more, but I would highly advise that you read a lot of the other Cosmere books before coming to this because I believe that this is his best one, so you don't want to ruin the others for yourself by reading this first. Finally, book number 14 of 2014 is The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. I actually listened to this as an audiobook and I really, really enjoyed it. It was very quirky, really fun. It's about a kind of romp around the universe where all sorts of crazy things happen and we meet aliens and the Earth blows up and it's all crazy. I loved it. I would highly recommend this series. I do not know if the next books are as amazing, but a lot of people have said that they are really cool still and really funny. It was originally based off of a radio show and you can definitely feel that in the way that it's written and the chattiness and the funny nature of it all. I loved it. I cannot wait to pick up more in the series. Yes, that is all of the 2014 amazing 14 books that I loved and cannot wait for more books in the series, and they're all good and just read all of these books is what I'm trying to say to you guys because they are amazing. Thank you all for watching and I will see you all very soon in another video. Let me know what your top 14 books are. If you've done a video, then link it to me in the comments and I will certainly go and check it out. Thank you for watching and bye! Me and you gonna have a little chat about the